Good morning, one and all. So let us start today's class. Today we'll start the last unit, that is fourth unit. So we have already completed a fifth unit. So let us start this unit, which is a very small unit. And okay, this is about limit theorems. The unit is about theorems which have limits. Now, so let us consider a sequence of random variables x1, x2, so on, xn, and how are they iid, which means independent and identically distributed, which means all these x1, x2, so on, xn are independent of each other, and furthermore they have a same distribution, which means they have a same mean mu and same variance sigma square. So each and every random variable has same mean mu and same variance sigma square, and furthermore they are independent of each other. Okay, now we have taken iid random variables here. This is very important. Now we are defining Sn, that is sum of first n random variables. What is Sn? Sum of first n random variables x1, x2 and so on, xn. Now, so here, since they are independent of each other, so let us calculate expectation of Sn. What is that? All are having same mean, so which means expectation of Sn equal to expectation of x1 plus x2 plus x3 so on xn. So obviously, and expectation of each and every random variable is what? Mu. So it is n into mu. I think I don't need to calculate separately. You're okay with this, I hope. Now what about variance of Sn? That is variance of x1. Why? Because since I told you they are independent, so simply you can write variance of x1 plus variance of x2 plus so on variance of xn. Since all are having same variance, so it obviously n into sigma square. So Sn is having a variance of n into sigma square. Now here, what happens? So Sn is having mean n mu and variance sigma square. So variance of Sn equal to n into sigma square. So here what happens? As n increases, Sn spreads, which means what? Why it spreads? Because as n increases, the variance increases. Here, if n increases, the whole quantity increases, which means the variance increases. So if variance increases, obviously it is indication of spreading. Actually, what is the variance? Suppose if you take the Gaussian PDF. So this is the spread. This is nothing but spread. It is given by sigma or sigma square. If the sigma square is more, there is a more spread. Isn't it? So that's why if n increases, the variance increases, obviously Sn is spreading. That is simple meaning. The Sn spreads out as n increases. Now, so we'll calculate one more quantity, we'll find out one more quantity, that is called sample mean. So that is called sample mean, denoted with mn. So here what happens? Sample mean is nothing but just like average. Suppose in a class there are three students, A, B, C. They got marks, let us take 3, 4, 5. What is average marks of all three students? What do? You take sum of individual marks of the students by number of students. So we do same thing in case of sample mean. That is just like finding the average. Sample mean means, so here we have n random variables which are IIDs. IID means independent and identically distributed. So what is the mean of these random variables? Obviously, so sum of all random variables x1 plus x2 plus plus xn by number of random variables, how many? N. So it is called sample mean. Now here, so what is the mean of sample mean? I mean expectation of mn. What is that? So in the numerator, otherwise, what is this actually? In the simplest word, what is this numerator? This is simple thing but Sn, isn't it? So this is Sn by n, isn't it? So what is the mean of Mn? That is expectation of Sn by n, isn't it? So then this is n into mu by n equal to n. So what is the variance of mn? And the method, what variance of Sn by n square? Are you okay with this? Because mn equal to Sn by n. So in the same way, what is the variance of mn? That equal to variance of Sn is nothing but n into sigma square by n square. That is sigma square by n. Now here what happens as n increases? In this case, what happens? If n increases, the variance decreases. As n increases, mn shrinks. As n increases, mn is shrinking. Otherwise, so it may tend to become zero. Why? Because if n is large, n tends to infinity, obviously variance tends to zero. In the simple sense, if n increases, variance decreases, it is shrinking. Okay, now, so in the first case, the PDF is spreading out. Now in the second case, it is shrinking out. Now, so we find out intermediate between Sn and Mn. Intermediate quantity between these two. So that is called Zn. Okay. Now, so let me go to this. Now, so this is Zn. How Zn is defined? Zn equal to Sn minus n into mu by sigma into root n. Now why are you defining like this? There is a reason for this. Let me explain this. First of all, what is Sn? Sum of first n random variables, that is x1 plus x2 plus plus so on. Xn minus n into mu by sigma into root n. Now, so what is the importance of this quantity Sn? here Zn equal to Sn minus n into by sigma root n. Now what is the expectation of Zn? Can you tell me? That is expectation of Sn here. So the only quantity which is random is this quantity. These are constants. Sn minus n mu by sigma root n. What is the expectation of Sn? We calculated this now. N mu minus n mu by sigma into root n. Obviously, this is zero. The mean is zero. Now, what is the variance of Zn? Let me write Zn here for your understanding. Now, what is the variance of Zn? What is that? That is simply variance of Sn by, why? Because so this is a constant, no? Variance of constant is zero. So by sigma square into n. Why? Because this is square term. This term will be squared. Is it okay? But what is the variance of Sn? That is also sigma square n by n sigma square or sigma square n. Which means, just now I have mentioned here, so expectation of Zn is 0, variance of Zn is 1. Since the mean and variance of Zn remain unchanged as n increases. Now in this case, the mean and variance of Zn are independent of n. They neither shrink nor spread. They are simply constant 0 and 1. Okay, that is about Zn. So let us study some inequalities. So these are some of the useful inequalities which we discuss in our course. Discuss first two inequalities. There is nothing but Markov inequality. It is very, very important. What it define, how it is defined is, if a random variable x can take non-negative values, then so probability of x of a is less than or equal to expectation of x by a for all a greater than 0. So I told you this inequality. Inequality means, which means it is greater than something or less than something. So x is a random variable which takes on non-negative values. Now what were you defining? So probability that x is greater than or equal to some quantity a is less than or equal to expectation of x by a. Obviously for all a greater than 0. What do you mean by this? So it is, this is inequality. This term is nothing but inequality. It is not the exact value. We are calculating inequality. Okay. Now, why these are useful? Okay. First of all, to calculate probability that x is greater than or equal to a, generally what a formula I told you? What a formula of this? How to calculate this term? It is nothing but a to infinity fx of x dx. If it is a continuous random variable, then it area under PDF is nothing but probability. No, so whenever this PDF is not available or it is difficult to calculate, then we go for inequalities. Here we are calculating the probability without knowing PDF. If you just know the expectation, you can calculate the probability. But remember, it is inequality. It is not exact value of probability. It is just inequality, but it is still useful. Okay, so that is the meaning of going for inequality. We go for inequality whenever the PDF is not available or it is difficult to calculate. So we find out the probability by using mean and variance, and these are not exact probabilities. They are simply inequalities. Inequality means it can be greater than or equal to something or less than or equal to something. It's a bound, something like bound. Okay, that is a real term for inequality. So that is a Markov inequality. So you have to remember this inequality. Now, so let X be a uniformly distributed on the interval 0 to 4. So for example purpose, I am defining the uniform distributed random variable. But here what I want to say that they gave you that X is uniformly distributed in the range 0 to 4. So in this case here we know PDF, isn't it? Okay, so let us draw the PDF. 0 to 4, this should be 1 by 4. X fx of x. Here we know PDF. Okay, but so let us see what will happen now. Now here, what is the mean of this PDF? I mean, mean of this random variable x. What is the formula? This is a, let us take this is b. That is a plus b by 2. That is 0 plus 4 by 2, 2. Now, suppose let us calculate this quantity. Probability that x is greater than or equal to 2. Using which inequality? Markov. What is this? Less than or equal to which quantity? So here, for your understanding, let me write the formula once again. Probability that x is greater than or equal to a is less than or equal to expectation of x by a. Compare these two. Here, what is a equal to 2, which means if I ask you what is the probability that x is greater than or equal to 2, which means it is less than or equal to expectation of x is 2, what is a also 2, which means it is less than or equal to 1. Okay. Now suppose if I ask you what is the probability that x is greater than or equal to 3, that is less than or equal to, here what is 3 now? This is a is 3 now. Mean won't change. So that is less than or equal to 2 by 3, expectation of x by a, that is 2 by 3, less than or equal to 0.67. Suppose if I ask the probability that x is greater than or equal to 4, that is less than or equal to, now a is 4, that is 2 by 4, so which means that is less than or equal to 0.5. Now till now what we got is just inequalities, but in this example they mentioned about PDF. Let us calculate exact probabilities. What do you do? Exact probabilities. So to calculate this, once again let me draw the PDF. Suppose if I ask you, so probability that x is greater than or equal to 2, what is this equal to? How to calculate? Simple. So greater than or equal to 2 means this area. How much is this area? This is a rectangle, height is 1 by 4, width is 2. What is the answer? 2 by 4, that is 0.5, which means, so the exact value of this probability is 0.5, but what our inequality says? Less than or equal to 1. Obviously, so 0.5 is less than or equal to 1. Correct? So this is a valid inequality. So the exact probability is 0.5, but the inequality says it is less than equal to 1. So it is correct. But what is the error? Maximum error 0.5. Okay. Now in the same way, if I ask you exact probabilities, what is the probability that x is greater than or equal to 3? Simple. You take this area, no? This area 3 to 4. What is this area? 1 by 4, that is 0.25. This is exact probability, but what is the inequality? X greater than or equal to 3 means 0.61. So 0.67 is 0.25 is less than 0.67. Okay, what is the error? This minus 0.25. Okay, now last probability, probability that x is greater than or equal to 4. What is probability? Greater than or equal to 4 means this area. This area. So there is no area. Obviously it is 0. But what inequality says? It is less than 0.5. So 0 is less than 0.5. So all inequalities are correct. But they have some error. So that's why it is quite loose. Markov inequality is said to be quite loose, because there is a huge gap between inequalities and actual or exact probabilities. So simply we call it as quite loose inequality. That is about Markov inequality. We use inequalities to find out the probabilities if there is no possibility of getting a PDF. Inequalities are bounds. They don't provide exact probabilities. They simply tell us that the probability is more than this term or less than this term. Okay. Now, so we go for one more inequality, that is called Chebyshev inequality. Here, x is a random variable. It need not be non-negative. Unlike Markov inequality, there x has to be non-negative. Here x can be any random variable, any value with a mean, mu and variance. So this is what you get. So you have to remember this Chebyshev inequality. So what it says is probability that mod x minus mu less than equal to, greater than equal to some quantity c is less than equal to sigma square by c square for all c. Obviously it has to be greater than 0. Now, so let us interpret this using Markov inequality. Please remember, here what I want to say is, let us take Markov inequality to prove Chebyshev inequality. What I do is, here I'll take square at the both sides. Okay, what I take is, I'll take this term x minus mu whole square. I'll take this term x minus mu whole square. It is positive, no? It is non-negative. So what happens? Probability that x minus mu whole square greater than or equal to some c square should be less than or equal to, according to Markov inequality, what do you write? What do you write? Actually, it should be expectation of x by c square. Here this is a. It is something like a. So, but here what do you write? It is less than or equal to expectation of x minus mu whole square by c square. But what is expectation of x minus mu whole square? What is this? nothing but sigma square, that is sigma square by c square. So it is true for all values, that's why probability that mod x minus mu greater than equal to some c is less than equal to sigma square by c square. This is a Chebyshev inequality. Suppose if there is another way of writing c equal to k into sigma, then what happens? Probability that mod x minus mu greater than equal to k sigma is less than equal to sigma square by, now this is a, now this is something like c, k square sigma square, both cancels, so that is less than or equal to 1 by k square. So here simply we can say that probability that mod x minus mu greater than equal to c is less than equal to, so instead of c I will write k sigma, that is 1 by k square. This is one way of writing this. Okay. So let us take this example. They are asking what is probability that mod of x minus 2 is greater than or equal to 1. Okay, so still here also they have mentioned same random variable, x is uniformly distributed in the range of 0 to 4. So anyway, this is not required, but I am drawing for your understanding purpose only. So what is the mean of this? Mean is 2. What is the variance? What is the variance formula? B minus A whole square by 12, that is 16 by 12 or 4 by 3. What they are asking? Mod of x minus 2 greater than, what is there in the problem? Greater than 1. So here what is 2? 2 is nothing but mu. So it is in the standard form of Chebyshev inequality. So what is this probability that mod x minus 2 greater than or equal to 1? Obviously that is less than or equal to. So what is the variance of, other way let me write, sigma square by c square. What is c here? This is c. How much? 1. So this is less than or equal to sigma square. So obviously this is less than or equal to sigma square, means what? Simply variance, that is 4 by 3. So that is the answer using Chebyshev inequality. Now here Chebyshev said to be, here I have written some statement, more powerful than Markov. Why? Because the bounds are little bit accurate compared to the Markov. Chebyshev is powerful because it is somewhat accurate. Yeah. So can you solve this? Last problem, x is exponentially distributed with a parameter lambda equal to 1 for c greater than 1. Now, so here exponentially distributed, x is exponential with lambda equal to 1. So here simply I can say that if lambda equal to 1 means mean and variance both are equal to 1. Why? Because it is 1 by lambda, 1 by lambda square. Okay, we have done these calculations in the last classes. Now, Suppose if I ask you this question, what would be the answer? So we calculate this one. What is this probability that x is greater than or equal to c? What is this answer? Using first of all, let us go with the inequality. So this is not in the standard form of Chebyshev inequality, isn't it? So let us do with the Chebyshev inequality first. Probability that what I do is I'll subtract 1 on both sides. Why 1? Because mean is 1. Why mean need to be subtracted? Because in the Chebyshev form we need to get x minus mu. Now but mod is missing. What I do? So that is obviously probability that mod x minus 1 greater than or equal to c minus 1. So this is further less than, now this is in the standard form of Chebyshev inequality. Yeah, instead of c we have c minus 1, that is sigma square by, actually we had c square, but here c minus 1 whole square. Are you getting or not? But what is sigma square? What is the mean of this random variable? That is also 1. So simply this is less than or equal to 1 by c minus 1 whole square. Now but what is the exact value, exact probability? X is greater than or equal to c, that equal to e power minus c. Do you remember this? Actually it is, what is that? E power minus lambda c. Since lambda is 1, it is e power minus. This is exact probability and this is inequality. So inequality satisfies the exact probability. Okay. So this is about some useful inequalities. Now, so stop here. Thank you.